I'm having a good time, they just trying to ruin it. Shout out to the fact that I'm the youngest nigga doing it. Cap on, brim, bend, dance, air time.
Hey ho, what's up guys, it is your boy Bugs, and in today's video guys, I'm going to be giving y'all the best PC settings for not the best performing PCs out of the bunch, and yeah, let's get into it. So the first thing you want to do is, for your view distance, make sure that's on epic guys. I don't care how bad your PC is, just make sure it's epic so you can be able to see your enemies as far as you can. And if your PC is really, really that bad, then you might want to put it on far, but never put it on near medium. That would be too much of a disadvantage for you. As for shadows, if your PC can handle it, go for it. Like for me, when I was on the PS4, I used to love shadows. When I heard about people on PC didn't play with shadows and hated it, I'm sitting here like, why do you hate shadows? Like, you get to see who's above you, who's below you, with the little black little circle fade. But I guess, you know, certain PCs couldn't handle it, and that's why people don't really use it, or they feel like it takes away too much from their frames. So that's why I also have it off, because my PC is not the best, as you can see from the right-hand corner. I'm capped at 120, just for the fact that my PC isn't the best. Now, as for texture, you want to put that as high. The reason why you want to put it high, and if you even can put it on Epic, definitely put it on Epic, but it just makes your game actually render and actually not get that stupid bug where, you know, the game is not rendering, and when you land, you get that little stupid, like, hovering glitch, and you can't, you know, build or shoot or anything because your game is not rendering and it doesn't know what to react. So that's why you always make sure that's on high, maybe even medium if your PC is that bad, but you might want it to be high and bring you down your distance just so you can have that texture rendering. As is for effects is like for gun bullets, seeing explosives and stuff. You don't really need that to be high. That could be as low as possible just to give yourself more FPS. And for as for processing, don't really matter about that, so that could be low. You can read on it to see what it exactly does, but it's not that needed. VSync, you don't need that on. Motion blur, you can take that off. I personally don't even really feel the difference with it on or off. Like, I used to play with it on because I think I just like the, like, I guess the sway blur that it gives me, but I took it off recently just to test it out, and I guess it makes me a better player. I'm not fully sure. Also, as for your FPS, make sure that's on, just for the fact that you can see your FPS when you're playing the game to see if, you know, if it's your performance that you're doing bad or if it's your system that can't handle it, which means you could change some of the settings and try to bring it down. But this is probably like the best settings that doesn't give you the least disadvantage, as in having it fully on Epic. Now, another thing I want to be teaching you is about the frame rate limit. So the first thing I believe you want to do is, after you get the right settings that you want, put your frame rate limit on unlimited to see where does your PC cap at. It'll have a high, it'll fluctuate, but it'll have a high of hitting like 240 and going down, 360 going down, you know, just a certain number. But let's say your PC is hitting around 190, fluctuating 180, 190, right? In my opinion, I think you should cap it at 160 or 140, or like literally like two levels of wherever your PC is downwards. And the reason why I'm saying that is just for the fact that it'll give you a better performance over quality. Yeah, quality is everything, but recently that I've noticed from playing on PC is this affects controller players the most. For the people that are on controller on PC and wondering why their controller is giving delay and why certain things are not running smoothly or happening smoothly as they're pressing the buttons, it's not you guys, it's actually your PC. Your PC is giving you quality over performance, which is making the game run smoother, cleaner, everything for ya, but your controls are just delayed. Even if it's plugged in or you're doing a remote play and your, you know, your motion thing is literally pointing at the PC, it's not you, it's actually your PC. So the reason why you want to do it is just for the fact to give you that performance so you don't get that stupid delay. And I'm telling you this by experience. My friend recently was playing on unlimited. He was getting 300 and something frames, which you don't even really need in Fortnite, in my opinion, unless you have like a crazy monitor that gives you that actual like visual view. But yeah, he was playing on it and he was always getting this weird random like delay. It wasn't always, but it was like here once in a blue moon. So I was wondering why that was happening, because when I even went over to his house and played on it, I was like, why is there a delay on the controller? Like, I can't play like this, this is so bad. So I was going through his settings and I saw that I was capped at unlimited. I'm like, well, why is it unlimited? Let me put it on 240, and it made the game run as smoothly as possible. As for keyboarders, I don't think that it really affects them, but recently I was told by one of my friends that switched to PC and just recently switched to keyboarding, seeing that he's been getting this weird delay too. And I asked him what his frame rate was on, he said he was on unlimited. So I think it does affect certain keyboards maybe, because he said that, because he doesn't have like a really, really good keyboard. It's just like a, I guess like a normal keyboard just for the time being. But I don't think a keyboard can really give a delay effect. For me playing on PC, even when I was younger with even trash PCs, I've never seen a a delay on the keyboard, so I think that's why. So guys, make sure you're not unlimiting your PCs. It's not good for you for performance. Quality-wise, yeah, it makes your PC and your game looks good, but it may fuck your controls up. So try to bring it down like a little bit. Like I said, if your PC is running at 240, like cap when you put it on limited, put it at 220, 200, because I don't know. I feel like it just makes the game run smoother for you and, you know, gives you the controls, the better performance. But yeah, guys, that's all I had to say for this video, man, for the PCs that aren't at the top performance, the little $900 PCs, the little 1K PCs that can't do what the 3K PCs could do and stuff, having 400 frames per second like them, because we're on a budget. But yeah, guys, hopefully this video do help you out with your PCs and wondering why your performance is a little shady if you did make the switch like I did, or any reason, you know, downgrading on a PC for a certain reason or anything. But yeah, leave a like if you like the video, guys. Comment about anything. Comment if you need any tips or any help, or you're having problems, and I'll try to my best to help y'all. And also, this is your first time ever watching one of my videos, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, guys. And I'm Bugs, and I'm out. Peace.
Niggas think I'm weird and they don't really like me, cause I can fuck your bitch and fuck your mom and auntie. Your girl's a fight, but your mom is a dying piece.